complete, let's review our top three today. Leclerc, Sainz, and more. Well, that wraps up qualifying, but don't worry, we'll be back tomorrow as we head into the Grand Prix. We're here today on the shores of the Red Sea in the Lower Hejaz Mountains to visit one of the newest circuits on the Formula One calendar. We're in Jeddah, home to what we all hope is going to be a thrilling Saudi Arabian Grand Prix. So with Jeddah already being one of the newest circuits in Formula One, it seems that the drivers will now also have to figure out how to tackle it in these unusually wet conditions. Like many other street circuits, this is a very technical drive. Some of these corners are challenging enough in the dry, so it's going to be interesting to see just how the drivers fare in this weather. So with the race not far away from starting, here's what today's grid rundown looks like. An immense lap from Carlos Sainz yesterday puts him in pole position, and Moore completes the front row. Considering the rest of the grid, we have Perez, Bottas, Charles Leclerc and Verstappen, Russell, Magnussen, Fernando Alonso and Esteban Ocon, Gasly, Tsunoda, Lando Norris and Hamilton. They'll be starting further back after an earlier grid penalty. Ricciardo, Vettel, Alex Albon and Guan Yu Zhou, Stroll and Nicholas Latifi. It's almost time for the lights to go out, so let's head down to the track where preparations are underway. Well, it's not going to be plain sailing for our drivers today, although with the sky falling as it is, perhaps sailing isn't too far from the truth. Anthony Davidson could be a wet one today. Great to have you with us. What are your thoughts?
It is a touch damp, isn't it? Well, as a driver, there are three big things to worry about when racing in these kind of conditions. Standing water, tyre temperature and visibility. Judging distance to the cars around you is really tricky when you're driving through the vast amounts of spray that these wet weather Pirelli tyres kick up.
Okay, now that we've got some good points on the board, let's continue this form and aim for another top 10 finish. Okay, so let's go through all the gears if you can. We need to make sure the engagement is okay before the start. We're going to want to put some temperature into the tyres. Okay, good parking there, mate. Now we need to make sure we get a great launch as the race starts. Keep an eye on the lights. The start sequence will begin as soon as the grid is formed. Be ready with the clutch. and some information on Leclerc. Okay, the officials have deployed the safety car due to multiple cars being stopped on track. Safety car in this lap. Safety car in this lap. Let's make sure those tyres are up to temperature. And remember, there's no overtaking until the timing line. Stay in position until the green flags. I've got some information on Hamilton for you. Okay, they're slowing down. It seems like there's some kind of problem with their car. Okay, let's get ready to go racing again. The safety car is in this lap. When the field accelerates, remember there's no overtaking until the timing line. Safety car in this lap. Okay, good job, mate. Really well done. That was a fantastic drive.
Sterling effort from the team and a magnificent drive to secure victory here at the Saudi Arabian Grand Prix. Well, Anthony Davidson, a resounding victory today, but what set them apart from the rest? Red Bull put up an outstanding fight for the front position today, and it's great to see it paid off for them. They do so much for the sport that you can't help but be delighted by today's race win. Position of points leader in the Drivers' Championship. Let's focus on the driver of the day, Anthony Davidson. Who do you pick?
Definitely Guan Yu Zhou, isn't it? No matter what the rest of the field threw at him, he didn't put a foot wrong. Superb drive from him.
It's time to see how things are shaping up in the Constructors' Championship. And pulling further ahead in the standings, it's Red Bull. Meanwhile, good work from Aston Martin this weekend, who pushed themselves further up the order. I'm equal parts exhausted and elated with this weekend of Formula One, so be sure to join us for the next one.
A reporter's asking who you see as your rival. We need your input. Thanks for handling that. Our new parts have completed without issue. They'll be on the car ready for the next race weekend.